जय जिनेंद्र सभी को। सौरभ जी आप है?
हाँ, मैं हूँ।
हाँ ठीक है सौरभ जी। सौरभ जी मैंने मंगलाचरण कर ले लिया है।
करते हैं, मंगलाचरण स्टार्ट करते हैं।
ठीक है सर।
मंगलमय मंगल करण वीत राग विज्ञान, नमो ताहि जाते भये अरिहंता दि महान, करि
अरे
मंगल करि हो महा ग्रंथ करण को कार, जाते मिले समाज सब पावे निज पद रास।
सौरभ
तो इट इज पेज नंबर 2। लास्ट टाइम वी वर ऑन कैरेक्टरिस्टिक्स ऑफ अरिहंत। पेज नंबर 3, इट मीन्स हियर वी स्टार्टेड, फ्रॉम हियर वी स्टार्टेड, देन वी वर ऑन। ओके, सो अरिहंतों का स्वरूप या कैरेक्टरिस्टिक्स ऑफ अरिहंता। टोडोमल जी, इन दिस चैप्टर और इन दिस यूनिट, इन फर्स्ट यूनिट, टेलिंग अबाउट अरिहंत। सो अ पर्सन हु हैज रिनाउंस्ड फ्रॉम द हाउस होल्ड अलाइव एंड एक्सेप्टेड मॉन्कहुड एंड हैज बीन अरिहंत बाय डिस्ट्रॉइंग फोर घाती कर्म, एंड ही इज हैविंग अनंत ज्ञान, अनंत दर्शन, अनंत वीर, अनंत सुख, एंड ही इज कंप्लीटली हैप्पी। देर इज नथिंग टू डू, इट मीन्स अरिहंत मीन्स देर इज नथिंग टू डू। दैट्स वाई ही इज सिटिंग इन अ पोस्चर विच इज रिवीलिंग नथिंग टू डू। Though he is doing something, but that is called self-realization. So last time we were discussing on this point, Anant Darsan, Anant Gyan, Anant Virya. God of God by becoming free from hunger, thirst, etc. Birth that, etc. It means Arihant means or God means or Lord means a person. A atma, a soul, who is free from everything, who is free from everything. Today Mahavir Jayanti, there is Mahavir Jayanti. So we have celebrated in the morning, and I think you will celebrate. So how you are celebrating today Mahavir Jayanti there?
Sarabji, at the mandir they have the program for the kids. So they are gonna be doing and they are gonna be doing puja, but the puja is mostly for online, and then they are gonna be doing the program for the kids at home. Our plan is to just do a little bit of swadhyaya and say one at least a few stutis of Bhagwan Mahavir.
Okay, so is there any kind of lockdown?
There is no lockdown, but again, I don't know if at the temple they will allow everybody.
We could not celebrate Mahavir Jayanti today here because here it is lockdown. But if we say that Bhagwan Mahavir, Lord Mahavir, was in Arihant Avastha, and Lord Mahavir is a 24th Tithankar, out of 24th number Tithankar, and it is called that we are in rule of Bhagwan Mahavir, in Shasan of Bhagwan Mahavir. So it has been almost 2600 years when Bhagwan Mahavir was here in this holy bhumi, in this holy land which is called Bharat. And what he delivered that time, that is called Divvidhvani. When he delivered, you know, there is a question which can arise in our mind or the mind of others. How you know all Jinvani? It means Adinath was there, so Teen Lok Varnan is there, Karmasthiti is there. Who told you about all these things? So we can say that our last Tirthankar was Bhagwan Mahavir. And Bhagwan Mahavir told us by the way of Divvidhvani. Gautam Gandhar accepted or heard his Divvidhvani, then other acharyas, they just provided Jinvani in written format. So we are in rule of Lord Mahavir. That's why we are celebrating Mahavir Jayanti. It means today, birthday of Bhagwan Mahavir. You know, Bhagwan Mahavir is only a single Tirthankar who took Diksha alone. It means when you will just, you are also watching the Tirthankar Bhagwan video, and you will notice there that when Tirthankar took Diksha, so there are 4,000 kings, 3,000, 200, 10,000 other person who just took also Diksha with that Tirthankar. But only Bhagwan Mahavir or Lord Mahavir or King Mahavir was only single out of 24 Tirthankar who took Diksha alone. So we can say that it has been not so long time when Lord Mahavir exists in this holy land. He was there. He was there only before 2016 years ago. We are having many proof of Indian culture, many proof of existence of Lord Mahavir. In Puratattva Vibhag, in government, there are many shilalekh. So Lord Mahavir, that time was in Arihant Avastha. So Arihant Avastha, it means he is free from thirst. He is free from death. He is free from birth. He is free from sweat. He is free from any kind of disease. He is free from anger. He is free from attachment. It means Lord, what is the definition of Lord? What is the definition of Arihant? The definition of Arihant, it means a person, a soul who is free from everything. He is having nothing. No death, no birth, no attachment, no aversion, not family, not any, here we will read it, not any sexual feeling, not any attachment, not any aversion. It means a supreme soul. Supreme soul, it means you cannot find any soul in this world like that. That is called Arihant. Supreme soul, it is Arihant. And this kind of God, maybe our idol. It means if we are trying to follow anyone. You know, usually I say to all students in my all classes, don't try to follow any person who is a worldly, because he may have attachment, he may have aversion. He may have his personal views, he may have his personal thoughts, because he is sansari. He is having worldly life. You cannot follow him. You cannot just consider him as an idol. So if you are thinking to accept someone as idol, so you can accept only two persons, Arihant and Siddha. We are talking about Arihant. Arihant, it means a person who is free from everything. Who is free from 18 dosh. He is having Anant Chatushtay. Though he is in samsara, but he is not human, he is God. So definition of God, of course, is very unique, and we can say that common people cannot accept this definition, because what usually it is said that, who is God? God, it means who can give something, who is also having feeling of attachment and aversion. If there is some devotee of that God, he may give reward to them, to him. And if there is enemy, so God must punish. If you are doing good, so someone must be there who can just give you something. A God, it means who can give you money. A God, it means who can punish your enemy. So this is not the definition of God, not as per Jainism, but as per Vastu Subhav. So I think it is very clear to all of you who is God. Last time we were discussing about God can give something or not. So we discussed that in Nischaya and Vyavaharne. So Vyavaharne just adopt a Bhakti Marg. Bhakti Marg, it means who adopts Bhakti Marg. So he usually say that, oh Lord, what I am having, even knowledge of Jinvani, what worldly things I am having, is only for your grace. It is you that who has provided me each and everything. But he knows by Nishchayana that God cannot give anything. So those person who are just going temple for demanding anything without knowing the Nayapaksha, it means he doesn't know, or people, they don't know about the characteristics of God or characteristics of Arihanta. One thing which I would like to say here, all are commonly Arihant. All soul are commonly Arihant. All soul, it means who has destroyed four Ghatiya Karmas. All are commonly Arihant. So here we are not talking about especially Tirthankar. You know, all Tirthankar are also Arihant. So we are worshipping Tirthankars in state of his Arihant Avastha. Okay. So all God, all soul who has destroyed four Ghatiya Karma, they are Arihant. And Tirthankar is a specialized title for a specific soul. So they are only 24 in one kal. Okay. Arihant may be many in numbers, but out of Arihant, Tirthankar can only be 24. Okay. So Arihant is a common word, and this can be applied on all holy souls who has destroyed four Ghatiya Karmas. So here, page number 3. Anyone will read here? Read from here.
Sarabji, one thing to add here is there is also a thing about people getting confused in terms of saying we are under the rule of him. Here the word rule is, you know, we are under the sashan of him, but we are just getting the teachings from him rather than, you know, them controlling something.
No. Ruling, it doesn't mean that he's controlling something. Ruling, it means he was the last Tirthankar who just told, who delivered speech, who just told Vastu Vivastha. So we are in rule, it means he was the last Tirthankar who told all Vastu Vivastha. Then we say that we are in Shasan of Bhagwan Mahavir. Shasan doesn't mean that he's a king and we are praja and he's ruling. He is giving orders, we have to follow. Rule, it means he was last Tirthankar. And last Tirthankar, it means he just delivered Divya Dhvani. And what we are using, what we are reading here, so that is the delivery of Bhagwan Mahavir. So of course, today is Mahavir Jayanti and we must think about Bhagwan Mahavir, you know. Have you been Mahavir ji here in Rajasthan? Anyone? Have you been Mahavir ji? Mahavir ji is a Tirth Chetra. It is Atishay Tirth Chetra, Mahavir ji. So. Okay, so. You know why it is so famous? Why Mahavir ji is so famous? You know?
No, Saurabh ji.
Anyone is there who can tell me why Mahavir ji is so famous? Else I'm telling, but if anyone is aware about why Mahavir ji is so famous. Okay, I'm telling. Why Mahavirji is so famous? You know, those person who doesn't know, those people who don't know about the Swarup of Mahavir, it means he couldn't marry. Bhagwan Mahavir had not any child, you know. But the place is famous for demanding children. So those husband and wife, those dampati who are not having children, so it is advisable to them, they go there and put some nariyal or just put some wish. Oh Lord, we have just completed 5 years of our marriage and we are not having any children. So we have heard that by your grace, we can have that. So that's why there is place especially famous for this. I think those people who are ignorant about the Arihant Swarup, they don't know that Bhagwan Mahavir was completely following celibacy. It means he couldn't marry. You can find that idol or place on internet. You will find the tale there. It is Atishay Chetra. Atishay Chetra, it means some special happenings was there. So a gwala, a cowboy, found this idol inside bhumi, inside soul. That's why it's famous. It's very famous, you know. So many people regularly just attend Mahavirji. I think this kind of things that Bhagwan Mahavir is capable to give a children. That's why many people are going there. So today is Mahavir Jayanti. We must know about the Swarup of Mahavir. Not only Mahavir, but also all Arihant, commonly Arihant. We must know the Swarup of commonly Arihant. Anyone who can tell me about Mahavir, who was Mahavir? A brief introduction anyone can give, if you know.
Yes, Saurabh ji, I can give.
Yeah, please.
So first of all, I wish very happy Mahavir Jayanti to all of us. Bhagwan Mahavir was our 24th Tirthankar. Today we are celebrating his 2620th anniversary, which is called his Jan Kalyanak. And why we call it the Jan Kalyanak? Because that was his last birth. Now, as you said rightly, that we are into the Shashan, or we are into the... Since he was the last Tirthankar, so we were into his Shashan. So that's why Lord Mahavir is very close to us. He was... Eventually, the story of Lord Mahavir, like there are a lot of, before his last birth, which we know as Mahavir Swami, there were a lot of births which were there. And before he was like the one of the common birth, which we know is like Mariji, when he was with, he was the grandson of first Tirthankar, Adinath Bhagwan. But before that as well, he was in the form of a bheel and he saved one Muniraj, and he took the oath of like he will not eat honey, non-vegetarian things and madhu, and then because of that he went into Swarglok. So from there his story started, and then he was like, it took like around one Kola Kodi Sagar, which was a very long period of time for he being to be into the last birth of Lord Mahavira. And he was being known with the 5 different names when his last when he finally became Arihant and then Tirthankar. In that birth, he was known with the 5 different names: Veer, Ativeer, Sanmati, Vardhaman, and Mahavir. And I think that's pretty much all about him. So, and now today is the day where we can celebrate and we can think about like what I can do as a person to become what he was, and how can I go into my soul and be like him.
Okay, good. So Bhagwan Mahavir was alone. It means he had not any girlfriend, he had not any wife, any children, anyone. You know, at the early age, he was very disappointed. Disappointed, it means he was very udasin from this worldly matters. His age was 72 years. It means at the age of 72 years, he went moksha.
Saurabhji, I think disappointed is not a word for that. I think it's indifferent. We should say indifferent. Disappointed indifferent, means okay. वो कषाय हो जाता है.
हाँ, I could not find a proper word in English. That's why I told you उदासीन.
Indifferent. Indifferent means detached.
Okay, so he was indifferent. He was उदासीन. So he was उदासीन from all this worldly matters. Indifferent means. And it means he just decided to become Muni very soon. Initially, he decided not to marry. And the result we are having that he is our 24th Tithankar. Though it is not ruled that if he could marry, so he could not be Tithankar. But he decided to become like that.
Sarabji, I have a question.
Yeah.
So, you know, like a lot of, when we say he was Udasin and then he took Diksha. So, do people take Diksha, you know, when they are really sad? I mean, out of the sadness? Or what type of bhav people have, you know, when they take Diksha?
No, it means Udasin, it doesn't mean he was sad. Sad and Udasinta is not an equal word. I mean, we cannot say that Udasinta and sad. Sad thing is different. It is also kasaya. Udasinta, it means if you know everything about this world, so inside your soul, there is a deep thinking. Why should I live in this world? Why should I adopt this domestic life when there is it is futile? There is nothing. It means I will not get nothing out of nothing. Why should I stay here? So indifferent, Udasinta, it doesn't mean that he was not laughing. Udasinta doesn't mean he was not talking with their parents, with their friends. Udasinta, it means he was in a deep thought. He was in the thought of Tatvigyan, that there is nothing in this world which is useful for me except my soul. So my soul is only mine. If I realize my soul, I can attain, I can get Anand Sukh. So Udasinta, it means he considered his soul only useful except other things. So this is Udasinta. And you cannot find any person, it means you cannot find Udasinta in that king, that prince or any muni. Udasinta is, you know, a very personal matter. So when we think about Bharaya Bhavana, so Bharaya Bhavana provides us Udasinta, not sadness. Udasinta, it means Bharaya Bhavana tells us about the reality of this world. When you know the reality of this world, so you can be just Udasin, not sad. So it is clear to all?
Arabji, I'm still not exactly clear the word Udasin, just because it's a Hindi word. But does that also mean that you are not considering the current paryay you are in, and you are not considering your body as yourself, and you are just thinking about your soul?
Yeah, because then he's very indifferent from everything. He is detached from everything. And he is not showing anything. He is not showing that I have detached and you must not talk to me. I will not do these things. They are doing everything. He is living. Prince Mahavir was living in his palace because his father was king. He was eating, he was sleeping, and he was not sleeping on floor, but he was sleeping on very soft bed, makmali bed. But Udasinta, it means he was realizing himself and considering all things which is not, which there is no use of all that. So Kunjanji, you are right. What you have understood about Udasinta, so that is right. All Samyadasti, all king, all princes who just achieve Samyak Darshan, who is going to be God, who is going to just achieve a state of moksha, they Udasinta is compulsory thing. Udasinta, it means to know the Vastu Sarup, to know the reality of this world. And only there is a one point of attachment, only one point of just realization, which is his soul. It is called Udasinta. So what I told you, that Bhagwan, Prince Mahavir was very Udasin since his childhood. as per the scriptures. And so that's why he could not marry. And his age was only 72. He got Arhyantavastha at the age of 40. Then he delivered his sermon, his Divyadhvani, till 72 years old, and Diwali. So today is Mahavir Jayanti. Mahavir Jayanti is main date of his birth, and Diwali is a date of his Keval Moksha. Early in the morning, he just went Moksha. So Diwali and Mahavir Jayanti. And I have told already that why we are celebrating especially Diwali and Mahavir Jayanti, because he's the last Tirthankar. That's why we are celebrating especially Mahavir Jayanti and Diwali. So this is the brief just discussion about Bhagavan Mahavir, because today is Mahavir Jayanti. And Bhagavan Mahavir was also Arhant. Okay. So in Arhant Avastha, in Arhant state, he delivered speech 42, 50, 60, 70, and 72, 32 years. Continuously, he delivered speech that is called Divyadhvani. And Bhagavan Mahavir was free from all those things which we are discussing, that greed, temptation, attachment, aversion, eating, sleeping, anything. Anything, what dosh we are having. It is called dosh. So they are free from all these things. Bhagavan Mahavir was in Arhantavastha and he is free from all those things. When Bhagavan Mahavir was there, so don't think that there were no other religion. There were all religion. Jain, but due to Bhagavan Mahavir, there is a Prabhutva. There was an influence of Jain religion due to Bhagavan Mahavir. But it is the dosh of Pancham Kal. It means, it is the nature of Pancham Kal. Pancham Kal, it means after fourth Kal, it is fifth Kal. That when Bhagavan Mahavir was there, so there were also many mat. And you know who is Bhagavan Mahavir? If we just see his previous birth, he was grandson of Lord Adinath. Bhagavan Mahavir, Jeeva Bhagavan Mahavir was the grandson of Lord Adinath. And he was disobedient the warning of Lord Adinath. It means Lord Adinath told in his Divyadhvani that this is the Marichi and he is going to become 24 Tirthankar of this era. Then he thought, oh, you have become one and I will be 24. No, I will show that I can be Tirthankar. At present, then he just established Mithyamat, many Mithyamat that time. So since then, we are seeing those Mithyamat. But at last, Bhagavan Mahavir or Jeev of Mahavir just achieved salvation, went moksha. And he is also Arhant. Right now, he is Siddh, you know, he is Siddh right now. But in state of Arhant, he was also just having all these things, this Swarup, what we are discussing here about the common Arhant.
Sarji, one thing that I have heard is the only another reason he's been considered amongst all the 24 Tirthankar is he's the only one who has gone to seventh Narak and come back to Devgati and then become Arhant as well as then Tirthankar. So I'm not sure.
Yeah, right. No, right. You know, the time difference between first and last Tirthankar is a million, trillions, billion years. You cannot count. So it is not possible. A person who has been Samyadasti, Chaik Samyadasti, and can just can be in this world for so long time. That's why his Bhavitavyata, just he dishonored the Divyadhvani or Vani of Lord Adinath, and he established many Mithyamat. Due to that, he wandered in this world. It means he went Narak, he became Triyanch, all these things. It is the right thing. Kunjanji.
Sir,
Okay.
Sir, Abhi. And this is another thing that I kind of think is as an inspiration to everybody, that if person can go to the seventh Nara and still become a Tirthankar, we as a human, at least who have the right way to make decisions, we should definitely be on the right path.
Yeah, of course, you know, you cannot underestimate yourself. If you think that I was in Narak, I was in Triyansh, how can I be God? You can be. Because Lord Mahavi was also in Narak, in Triyansh, in Ekindriya Ped, tree. But at last, he became Lord. It means we can also be, we can also get that kind of avastha, which is called Aryan. So we are discussing about common avastha Aryant, and also discuss about Arihant Mahavir. So this is very important point, that Arihant or God, a person who to whom we can say God, a person who is free from hunger, thirst, death, birth, all sorts of physical maladies, and whose body has turned into the supernatural paramodaric body. Supernatural, it means it is called our body is odaric, but his body is paramodaric. Paramodaric, it means he is not having blood, flesh, and bone. His body is like, we can say, crystal, sphatic money. It's very pure and clear. So paramodaric, it means our body is having a sapta kudhatu. Kudhatu, it means blood, all these shit we are just having in our body. So, but Arihant is not having all kind of these sapta kudhatu. Okay, all mal, it is called all kind of mal. All sorts of physical maladies, and whose body has turned into the supernatural paramodaric body, having no weapon or clothing, and is devoid of the censorable signs of the symptoms of sex feeling, anger, etc. A remarkable thing. He is having no weapon or clothing. He is not having any weapon or clothing. Can anyone can tell me why he is not having any weapon and clothing?
They are considered the forms of Parigraha, as well as the part of Himsa.
Mm-hmm. Okay. Amiji, could you tell me why he's not having any clothes and weapon? If you know, you can tell me.
Sorry, right now, too much noise over here. So, can you repeat the question again, Saranji?
Yeah, my question is that here it is God or Arihant is free from clothing and weapon. So, can you just tell me why he is free from clothing and weapon, etc.?
Maybe because he is completely detached, so he doesn't feel any kind of need for any of that.
He is detached, okay. But at least some weapon he may have if he is unable to just protect himself. How he can protect us?
Because again, he's detached. He doesn't feel the fear of losing anything. So he doesn't need any protection for that.
Yeah, that is important thing. He is not having any fear to lose anything. That's why he's not having any weapon. You know one thing? What I was reading a book, which is a history of Jainism. So I found there one thing. There are a specific group of people in Digambara and Shvetambara Jain. They do not believe in Murti Puja. In Digambara, they are called Samayya. And in Shvetambara, they are called Terapan, Thanagvasi, right? So I was reading a history regarding this. Why it is so? So it was 13th, 14th century, and Mughal continuously just they attacking on India and on our cultures. So they noticed one thing, that the Jainis are very just stuck with just Murti Puja. So they destroyed many temples. And you know what the logic they gave? They gave the logic, your Lord cannot save you himself, then how he can save your, save yourself? How he can protect yourself? So, though many Jaini who were intelligent, they refused to accept this logic because they knew the intention of Mughal. But some sect of Jaini, they think that they are saying right, Murti Puja. So, you know, Mughal is against Murti Puja, completely against Murti Puja. Even they are having very dvesh kind of things, those who are having Murti Puja. So they gave this logic, and some of our Jainis accepted this, and they start this kind of parampara, and continuously we are just having. But there are very few, you know, they're not lots in number, but they are very few. So if we see the idol of Lord or Arihan, they are free from clothing, they are free from weapon, and is devoid of all censorable signs of symptoms of sex feeling, anger, etc. Anger, greed, man, pratistha, anything. If we abuse God, don't worry. God will not retaliate. God will not respond. God will not do anything bad in your life if you are abusing him. One thing is also there. If you are admiring him, if you are worshipping him, if you are using good word to him, so he is not going to give you any reward. This is the definition of God, you know. When I was in 10th class, it's very clear in my mind so far. It was examination of math. So, you know, in India, most of the children, they are very afraid of math. So it is very clear in my mind that there was an examination of paper of math. And I was standing before Lord Parasnath. And I was saying that, oh, Lord, please, just mercy on me. I want to get good marks in math. Because after 10th class, I will be promoted in 11th class. And I was thinking to take commerce, and I would like to appear in IAS exam. So that was 10th was very important for me. You know, right now when I think that how ignorance was there when I was child, I was saying to God, oh Lord, please mercy on me and please give me good marks in my math paper. Of course, that was the state. When I was not aware the sarup of Lord, that Lord cannot give anything to you. But you know, Prayaji, Lord heard about my request, and I got good numbers in mathematics. It was out of expectation. I got good numbers in distinction, I think. Me or Gaurabji, we just got distinction in that. I was very happy that time, you know, and I just put 5 rupees in temple. It is also remember me. But when I'm thinking right now, what was the state? What was the thought? God is free from all these things. God is free from anger. God is free from just temptation. If you are doing these things, it is against the sarup of God, or you don't know sarup of God. So I think it is very clear to all that the supernatural or paramodharic body he is having no weapon, no clothing, and is devoid of all sensory sign symptoms. It means no anger, no sex feeling, no greed, no man, nothing. So this point is clear to all or not? He is free from all. Rohanji, is it clear that he is free from all?
Sorry, can you repeat the question, please?
Is it clear that he is free from anger, greed, sex feeling, anything? He is free from all things?
Yes, Sarathi.
You know, this point, if it is, if we are having clarity on this point, there will be no doubt in the life whether should I demand anything or not from God. Whether should I abuse God or whether should I just praise God. I will send you, you know, I will send you one bhajan, which is very favorite for me. So, lines of bhajan is like that. Tumhare darsh bin swami mujhe nahi chain padti hai. Tumhare darsh bin swami mujhe nahi chain padti hai. So, it is old bhajan written by Kavivar, I think, Budjan or Daulat Ramji. But it's very favorite for me. You must listen that I will post on our group. If you are unable to understand any line, you can tell me. So I will clarify that. Lord is favorite for us. Lord is respectable for us. Of course, we must think about him. But here, what Torumalji is saying that God is free from all kind of emotions, all kind of worldly feelings, all kind of worldly vikar. It is thirst, hunger, etc. Now, it is very clear reason to all that why we are not in a manyata of distributing prasad in a temple. You know, in a temple, there is no concept of prasad. Anyone there who know the concept of prasad in other temples? What is the concept of prasad? And we are not having this concept, but other temple, other religion, they are having prasad concept. Pritesh ji, could you tell me what is the concept of prasad? I don't know English meaning of prasad.
I don't know what mean. They do give in Hindu temples. They do give prasad. We do not give prasad. I think they consider that as a blessing. Especially when I used to live with a roommate who was ISKCON member, they used to serve Naivedya like we do to Bhagwan. But the problem was they were like the same food that you serve them in the morning, you put that back in the thing and then eat it, and it makes it more powerful or more charged. They had some concept. So it sounds like they consider food as blessing. And when we do Naived, our difference is that when we do, we are trying to get rid of our taste by offering the best to Bhagwan. So totally different concept.
Mm-hmm. Okay. So
I think the belief which is there is like there is a basic difference between Jainism and the other religions. Like they believe there is a God. So when they believe there is a God, he himself can eat or drink something, right? And that whatever he can eat, the leftover is never known as prasad for them. And that's why they consume it. And they feel that this is what we have. So for example, if I took something to, say I take an apple and I go to Ram Mandir and I put it over there. And or say halwa, for that matter. And whatever has been left out, I will say that this is a prasad because Bhagwan has taken the bhog. And what is left out is like the devotees can take through and they can eat because it become a prasad now because God has already taken it, a part of it. But in our case, we believe that the definition of God itself is different for us as Vitragi Sarvagya Nito Abdishi. So he cannot eat, drink anything. So there is no concept of having prasad in Jainism.
Yeah, Ranji and Pritesh ji, your both answer is right. Of course, they are offering bhojan or many delicious recipes, many delicious mishthan. They are offering to God because they think that God in a state of hunger, he may be thirsty. If I just put any modak, laddu, so it is his favorite. And what is left over? So that is prasad. It means it is his blessing, what we are receiving. So it may provide us peace, prosperity, power of our body, and this prasad is also having power. this is the concept. And they are not commenting on that concept, but we are seeing that our concept is quite different. What Rohanji and Apteshji just told. Lord of Jainism is free from thirst and hunger. So why, how anyone can offer a food to them, food to God? Is it not possible? Because we know he is free from hunger and thirst. There is one word, Prabhavana. Prabhavana is a different thing and Prasad is a different thing. So Prabhavana, you know, when there is a Daslakshan or any special occasion, so if there is some person who told the trustee of temple that we would like to distribute something as Prabhavana, so some just distribute peda, some distributes just dry fruits, some distribute kesar, but not inside the temple. They just stand outside the temple, and when devotees just they are coming from there, so one by one, they very in very humble manner. It is Prabhavana. It is Prabhavana. So Prabhavana and Prasad is very different thing, you know. So this is the reason. When I was a child, the question was, you know, it was very common question in my mind. Why in Jain temple I am not receiving prasad? Because I used to go other temple also. So I was a child in 7th or 8th class. So I usually have a plenty of prasad from many temples because my friend was there. So I usually thought that time, oh, in my temple there is no prasad. You know, for some time I stopped to go there. Then my mom asked, why are you not going temple? I could not give any answer. And I, in a very slow voice, I told her, and by tomorrow I will go. But in Pathsala, my teacher just clarified that why we are not having prasad concept. And we are just discussing about this concept here in Swarup of Aryan. So I think it is very clear to all why we are not having a concept of prasad. Okay, and prasad and prabhavana is a different thing because our God is free from all these things which is called hunger, thirst, anger feeling, etc. feeling. So don't worry. People say that Bhagwan se to daro. Usually we just hear this dialogue in Hindi movies or in common people that Bhagwan se to daro. But don't worry. There's no point to be afraid from God. Why? Because God is free from anger. God is free from hunger. God is free from any greed. God is free from attachment and aversion. So please, no need to be afraid. Is it clear? Anyone is there who is scared of God? That Bhagwan se to daro. Rohan ji, Bhagwan se to daro.
Probably after reading Swadhyaya and understanding the concepts, things have changed. Earlier when like there was no clarity about this, of course this dialogue suits to you like, yeah, there is someone who you have to, is a superpower or there is God, who are you? But now since you have a belief that you can only become God, so it's about yourself, your own karma.
Okay, good. So there is no concept which just... which tells us about Bhagwan se to daro, because our Bhagwan is free from anger. So etc. for our full disposition and emotions, and by whom sermons of Dharma Tirtha. So now matter is changed. It means who is Tithankar? Who is Arihant? So one thing here is that he is delivering a speech. So now we are talking about Tithankar, because Dharma Tirtha Pravartita hai. Dharma Tirtha, it means due to his speech, on the basis of his speech, he is delivering his speech and he is having Keval Gyan. And in Keval Gyan, he is capable to know each and everything. It means in a single moment, single samay, he is capable to know everything of three kal, teen lok, alok. He is capable to know each and everything in a single moment. That's why Arhant Bhagwan Or Lord Arihant, what he's delivering in his speech, in his Divyadhani, is not from his thought, but he's telling the thing which is really exist in this world. If he's telling this, that the nature of water is Sheetal, he is having a cold nature. Karela is having bitter nature. Neem is bitter nature. He is telling Vastu Subhav. If your soul is pure from the point of view of Dravyarthiko Nischayana, but he is Malin from the point of view of Vyavaharna. So Arihant Bhagwan is telling us about Drav, Gun and Paryaya, about Vastu Subhav, because he is not delivering or he is not telling anything what he thought, but what is in Vastu Subhav, he is telling only that thing. So Dharma Tirtha Pravarta, it means he is delivering his speech, and it is the speech of Lord Mahavir right now what we are having. Though we are learning Moksha Marga Prakasak, so after 2-3 pages there will be a topic when Toramalji will clarify that though I am writing this granth, but the main words, the main thought, the main delivery was not from mine, but it is from God, and I am only a messenger who is writing or who is delivering this message. So asya mool granth kartara sarvagya deva, who is the mool writer of this granth is Sarvagya Deva, because he is delivering his speech. Anyone is there who is willing to ask question?
Sir, Saurabhji, I had one question. So do Tirthankars get old like we do? Like Mahavir Bhagwan took Diksha at 30 and he became Arihant at 42, at the age of 42. And 42 to 72, he was in Arihant Avastha, or he was delivering Samvatsaran, or he was delivering his speech. So do they get old like us?
Do they on? What is your question? Do they on? Last word I couldn't hear.
Do they get old?
No Tithankar. You know, no Tithankar. They are always young. They could not grow old. They are always young. And as we have read here, Param Odarik Sharir. In Tithankar Avastha, it means when he was in domestic life. So his body structure, the Paramanu of his body is like that he could not grow old. And Arihant Avastha, he is having Param Odarik Sharir. Param Odarik Sharir, it means now he is free from all old, it means Paramanu of Odarik Sharir, which can just grow old, which can just provide you fair complexion, dark complexion. So he cannot grow old.
So this applies to all Samanya Arihant too, right? Any Arihant?
Yeah, right.
After
all Arihant.
After attaining Arihant Avastha, you get old, or you don't get signs of being old.
Yeah, no. Because he's free from everything, you know. He's free from everything.
Okay.
So it is second, it is the matter that he is delivering his speech in his Divyadhani. Now it is time to just to complete a class. First thing, I would like to tell you here that all Jinvani, all the scriptures what we are having is from Kevali Paramatma, especially we can say that it is from Arihant Paramatma. So if we know the clear Swarup of Arihant, definitely we will understand Jinvani in proper way. And if we are unable to understand the Swarup of Arihant, we will not be able to understand Jinvani in proper way. So first of all, if you are willing to get moksha, if you are willing to get sukh, happiness, peace, you will have to study Jinvani. And if you would like to study Jinvani in proper way, you would like to have Saddhan, proper Saddhan, So first of all, in primary stage, you will have to understand the swarup of Arihant, characteristics of Arihant. Then you will accept that characteristics. Then you will read Jinvani. So that will be very beneficial to you. But it is very difficult, you know. It is very difficult because in day-to-day life, you and me, both we are meeting too many persons. Not, I'm not talking about who are not Jain, but I'm talking about Jain. They are having same feeling. Usually in my business life, there are many my Jain clients. In my routine life, there are many Jain clients. Many persons to whom I know. They usually say that, oh, Saurabh ji, by the grace of God, Bhagwan ki kripa se aaj maine bahut kamaya. Oh, Bhagwan ki kripa se everything is fine. That's why I am regularly going Tijara ji. That's why I am going regularly going Sikhar ji. That's why I am going regularly Mahavir ji. Because when first time I went Mahavir ji, then I just had a tremendous profit in my business. But you know, I never explain the swarup of God to them because it is not the matter. It is not a moonfully, you know, it is not moonfully that in a single moment you just can eat it. In my whole life, even I just did not explain swarup of Arihant to any person who is just, we can say that, who is a common people, who is going from Rasta, and I just explain the swarup of Arihant. Because, you know, it is a very serious matter. It is a very serious matter. He is having a firm belief that what I am having in my worldly life, what I am having in my business, there is only by the grace of God, by the grace of Mahavir, by the grace of Parasnath, by the grace of Adinath. So that's the reason I did not explain anyone about the characteristics of God. Though we are having a proper class, you are keen to understand. That's why in detail we are discussing about the swarup of Arihant. So it is very clear to all why it is very important to understand the swarup of Arihant. Next time we will just complete it and we will discuss about Divyadhani and other characteristics of Arihant. Again, happy Mahavir Jayanti to all. And Jinvani Stuti. Very good. Very good. What is the name of your son, Kunjanji? What is the name of your son?
No, Saurabh ji, Rohanji ka beta lag.
Okay, Rohanji ka?
Kriyan,
Kriyan is very good.
He was actually waiting for this.
Yeah, Priyans, I will send toffee on WhatsApp, okay? So your papa will deliver to you. I will send on WhatsApp and your papa will purchase from market and he will provide you, okay?
Okay, thank you. But you are more good than that.
Okay, Jinvani Sthiti Balaknike. Very good. Okay. Jajnan. See you next time.
Thank you, Hardik. And Mahavir Jayanti, Hardik,
Shubhkamnaen. Okay, thank you.